There was nobody I liked in the other two parties. And, you know, I wanted to caucus with these guys before. They just haven't done it. They didn't do it the past two cycles. So I was really excited to find out that they were going to be here tonight. So I could come and not have to think about Republicans or Democrats because I'm fed up with all of them and don't like any of them. I think it's a lot more laid back here. People didn't really come here with rabid support for anybody, which is fine. If you're undecided, it makes it a little harder for people to... for you to find somebody to kind of help push you in one direction or another. I decided I would go for McAfee, but there are a lot of people here for Johnson. I think McAfee's just the right kind of crazy that we need for this race.
Isn't that the story of this election cycle?
It seems that everybody's got their own crazy, their own form of crazy, but I'm a libertarian form of crazy, I always have been, and will continue to be probably for a while. As long as they stop asking me for money. My money's my own. That's very libertarian.
That's what you're going to spend on tacos, right?
Exactly. Taco Tuesday, best time for a primary. Super Taco Tuesday.
So what is he? He's at? What's it
It's a fun party. The Democratic and the Republican caucuses are held at churches and schools. Ours is at Whiskey Junction. I mean... we're definitely not an uptight bunch of people, you know. I was the state chair and then the CD5 chair, which is a congressional district for Minneapolis and most of the western suburbs. Until tonight, I am moving to Texas. I've given up on Minnesota politics. I first became a libertarian in the 1990s, last century. I was handed a little quiz. And they said, answer this, answer that. I said, fine. I was walking at the time. And the guy looks at me and he had a surprise on his face and he says, you're a libertarian. And I said, I don't even know what that is, what a libertarian is. When Jesse ran against Norm Coleman and against Humphrey, I remembered. And I said, well, I'm a libertarian. And these guys are all idiots. Coleman used to be a Democrat. Now he's running as a Republican. Jesse, my goodness, I mean... come on. And then Humphrey, he's only there because he's a popular name. First time I ever voted as a libertarian. I ran for office against Steve Simon. He had $100,000 and kicked my ass. And he's now Secretary of State, even though I embarrassed him in debate after debate. But it sharpened the message. And I continue to do it because more and more people... listen. If they didn't, I'd quit. Why wouldn't I? But they do. They listen. And if you continue to get positive feedback, you'll continue to talk. And that's what I've gotten. When I took over as the chair, we had $800 in the checking account, and Andy, who had recruited me to be chair, hadn't been paid in a month. And I said, you know what we're going to do? We're going to give the people the opportunity to show that they care. So we did a GoFundMe type fundraiser thing. We raised $6,000 in 48 hours and was off to the races since then. We got booths at state fairs and different parades and different events. So our outreach is really big, really important. And now we're a sustainable party. I can be replaced, the next guy can be replaced because we're now sustainable. The Libertarian Party in Minnesota, that the actual members themselves are pretty much average people as far as I'm concerned. You'd think, oh, to be a big advocate in a third party, it must be, maybe a little extreme or that kind of thing. I haven't seen that at all. I've seen, real humble people, pretty well educated, more so than not, that really care and really want to make a difference, have tried in other arenas, failed in other arenas, not necessarily because of their actions, but because the system itself is pushed back.
A bumper sticker for the Libertarian Party would be peace, prosperity, and freedom. That's kind of our bumper sticker.
I was the state party secretary, and then I ran for U.S. Senate for the Libertarian Party in 2014. I've been politically active for a really long time, but I'm also a single mother and a student at Hamline University, so I'm very busy. I had to take a step back from politics to focus on my own personal career and responsibilities, and then I'm always the type to get involved, so it's hard to say no to everything. Most people assume all libertarians are rich white people. That's absolutely not the case. I grew up in a poor single-parent family. I know what it's like to be part of the system and dependent upon the system, and I have learned that the free market is probably the best way out of the system to independence. Well, in running for office, I actually discovered in a lot of states, in our state and other states, election law kind of rigs the system in favor of Democrats and Republicans. People say it's impossible to get out of that two-party binary. You can no longer fall into the, well, you have to vote for the best of the worst. It's really a time for people to choose something to vote for and to support rather than just constantly be against. So libertarianism has this reputation of being not caring or very cold or brutalist. It's not really that way. We just feel that the government itself is taking advantage of the masses for their own particular agenda.